All right, so Kenneth in Glendale, how are you?
I'm fine. How are you two?
Pretty good.
Good, Kenneth.
I've been watching the show for a while now.
Mm-hmm.
And I am theist. I do believe in God. I'm just really... I don't believe religion at all.
Okay. So... Do you, okay, I have to ask you to kind of define or describe the God you believe in and why you actually believe in this God.
Wait, I'm sorry, what?
In order to kind of address this, I'd need you to define or describe the God in which you believe and then explain why you think that God exists.
Conceptual God, I guess you'd say.
Well, a conceptual God is not an existing God. I mean, I have a God concept. I probably have several of them. But I don't think they exist.
I'm personally not too sure about it.
Well, that's fine. But I mean, I'm just asking you what you believe in and why.
I believe that God exists, that God created the universe, most creatures.
Okay. And why?
I can't conceive any other way that it could have come by.
Okay. So, imagine, first of all, I'm confused about, you think there's a God that created the universe and created most creatures, so other creatures, I'm assuming you're like God's...
I believe in evolution.
Okay. So, yeah. But your reason for believing is that you can't see any other way that it could have happened.
Yes.
Then wouldn't the answer be, why is it that you're believing an explanation that isn't an explanation? You can't even describe this God other than this is the thing that does the things that I don't have an answer for.
Right.
Right. And so the thing that does the things that you don't have an answer for is actually not an explanation. It's an attempt to solve a puzzle with a mystery. It is an attempt to ease yourself from the discomfort of admitting that you don't know. And wouldn't it be much better to just say, I don't know. I don't have an explanation for this. Hopefully someday we'll figure it out. Maybe I should explore it. But it's really distressing and uncomfortable for me to be in this position of not knowing. But I'd rather be honest and admit that I don't know than believe something for which I don't have any good reasons to believe.
Personally, I was raised in a full Christian household.
Mm-hmm.
Even my mother, at the moment, is planning to be a pastor.
Okay.
I just have a hard time thinking of anything that doesn't consist of having a God.
Yeah,
being
but
raised that way my entire life.
Right. So you've been indoctrinated to this non-answer, basically, where you run across something that's bigger than you, bigger than you're able to explain, you've been trained to be comfortable to just say, oh, well, that God did that. But if you really look at the nuts and bolts of your reason for believing, I believe this because I can't think of any other way it happened. If you were on trial for murder and the prosecution said we should convict you because we can't think of any other person who did it, does that say anything at all about whether or not you actually did it?
No, it does not.
And right. It's pretty much the same way with what you're describing. Now, I don't think that belief is incredibly harmful, but it's about the process by which you form that belief.
And if you're not a big fan of not knowing the answer to things, I mean, go ahead and ask yourself, how could a God exist in the first place? You know, you're invoking the God as the explanation for the physical world, but where did the God come from? You don't know the answer to that either. Are you going to make up an Uber God that created that God? Is it gods all the way down? At some point, you have to say, look, you know, I'm going to stop making things up to answer questions to which I don't have accurate answers.
Yeah. I mostly call the show. I am actually I'm thinking a lot about why do I believe in this? Mm-hmm. Why can't I really accept any other logical answer or theories of how this all came to be except for that?
Yeah, it's the thing that I think you probably should work a little bit on is just getting comfortable with acknowledging that you don't know, rather than saying, I can't come up with a better answer for this, because the answer you have, it doesn't explain anything. God, as I've said before, has no explanatory power. It is, by definition, a panacea, a cure-all. It is everything that we don't know, we can just insert a God there as the explanation for it, because gods are magic. But they don't tell you anything about the how or the why or the what. They don't add any useful information to the conversation. And they all it really does is help you be comfortable with not having to say that you don't know. When in reality, you don't know, and you don't even have any good reason to believe. I mean, you don't even know that a God is possible.
Yeah, that's correct.
And so if you've got this, you know, hey, where did the universe come from? That's a great question. It may be a terrible question when we finally find the answer. It may be that we asked the wrong question to begin with, and that helped us get to the right question. I mean, I don't pretend to know enough about the subject to even know how good the question is ultimately going to be. But as it sits right now, hey, what is the explanation for the universe? Why is there something rather than nothing? You know, how did this come about? And the second you say, well, God's the best explanation that I can come up with, that is a roadblock to further inquiry. And it also trains you to insert non-answers whenever you get stuck.
Yeah. It's, you know, it's reasonable if you have an unanswered question and you have incomplete information to answer that question with. It is reasonable to tentatively go with something that looks like it has a little evidence in its favor, but you can't be certain that that's absolutely answered it, but you want to feel like you're on a track, right? You can go ahead and latch onto that thing, but a God isn't one of those things, because there's no reason to think one exists in the first place. There's no understanding of how it could have come into existence, no understanding of the processes through it which it would have done any of the things you're trying to credit it with, right? So you know, it's not stupid to want to look for the best answer you can, but just be careful not to latch on to one that isn't an answer at all.
And every time that throughout history that we've had a phenomenon and we posited a God as an explanation for it, every time we've done that and actually gone on to find the real explanation, it's never been a God. Ever.
I know this.
So, I'm sure you do. So, the type of God that you're believing in, to the extent that you've described it, is not one that's dangerous in the religious sense. I mean, you know, you can't really set up a jihad based on this nondescript God that created everything and evidently hasn't done anything since. It's only dangerous in an intellectual sense in that it allows you to ease your discomfort about not knowing, which can prevent you from finding real answers and might encourage you to accept more bad answers in the future. And that's my primary objection to, you know, deism and pantheism and all these things that don't really add anything to the conversation. A God that doesn't exist is indistinguishable from a God that exists and doesn't do anything in reality. So,
okay.
Yeah.
Anyway, I hope that helps, Kenneth, and feel free to call us back if you get if you have other questions and stuff. Just be ready for I don't know.
All right. Well, cool. Thank you for having me.
Thanks much.